हेलो फ्रेंड्स एंड वेलकम टू एल के पी प्रेजेंट्स वीकली कमोडिटी आउटलुक। आई एम जतिन त्रिवेदी एंड आई शैल प्रेजेंट टू यू सम इम्पॉर्टेंट की इम्पॉर्टेंट ट्रिगर्स फॉर दिस वीक्स कमोडिटी मार्केट्स मूवमेंट एंड वी शैल ऑल्सो डिस्कस अबाउट सम की इम्पॉर्टेंट अपॉर्चुनिटीज़ फॉर कमोडिटीज ट्रेडिंग दिस वीक। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विद सम की इम्पॉर्टेंट नोट्स दैट आर गोइंग टू बी वेरी इफेक्टिव फॉर कमोडिटी प्राइजेस। फर्स्ट एंड फॉरमोस्ट एज यू ऑल नो दैट द कोरोना वायरस केसेज एक्टिव केसेज हैज़ बिन राइजिंग एंड दिस हैज़ directly impacted the non-riskier assets, the safe havens like gold and silver on a bullish run, and still the market is looking pretty well for gold and silver to go on the upside for short term, at least for the short term as well. Looking at the picture where the coronavirus impact has been very negatively impacting all of the markets, but there is some silver lining and some positive news as well. As we have seen, there are some drugs also being coming out for the active cases, and the number of active cases are dropping very sharply. Due to that, we have seen some good amount of risky assets performing as well, like just like equities as well. We have seen strong performances there. So we can expect some price corrections at these levels in the bullion market as well. Since the unlock phase one has been started and globally there has been the phases of unlocking being initiated, these are helping the industries and the industrial numbers going ahead as the work keeps on progressing. This will impact the base metals on the positive side. So let's start how directly it will impact the prices and the commodities itself. First and foremost, let's talk about gold. Gold prices have been hovering very steadily at the levels of around 47,500 to 48,000 in the last couple of days, and the prices are looking very bullish as of now, but we can expect some corrections from these levels because some exhaustion is being witnessed at the levels of around 48,000. Prices are failing to hold the levels of 48,000 and above in the recent past, and since we have seen a very strong uptrend in the prices, we can expect some corrections in a very short time and for a very small time as well. So we can expect to the levels of around 47,000 to 47,200 odd levels in the near term. Strictly the levels which are important as of now are 48,300 on the upside. If the prices crosses this figure, 48,300, we can expect some strong short covering happening towards the levels of 49,000 as well. So keep in mark, 48,300 on the upside is a very crucial important hurdle, and on the downside, 47,000 is a very strong support zones. Now let's start talking about silver. Silver prices have been trailing behind gold prices, but more or less it has been trading in the range. A range of around 46,000 to 49,000, that has been the broad range for silver prices. And now since the prices have come near the levels of 49,000, we are seeing some sluggish movement in silver prices as well. As we have seen the gold prices taking some halt or showing some sluggishness at the levels of around 48,000, we are also witnessing the same in the silver prices as well. So they are not finding it very difficult, the silver prices are finding it very difficult to cross and hold above the 49,000 mark. So we can assume in the coming next days, we can expect some price corrections in silver as well behind gold. So level to watch out for in silver is importantly is 49,250. If and all if it crosses 49,250 on the higher side, we can expect some strong short covering and fresh buying as well, which may take the prices beyond 50,000 in coming days. But if the prices do not cross 49,200, we are expecting some strong corrections as well in silver prices towards the level of 47,000 to 47,500. That is about 1,000 to 1,500 points downside rally we can expect. So that is about the bullion markets. Now let's move on to the energy pack. Talking about the energy pack, crude has seen a very strong rise in the prices, as we have seen the Brent crude crossing the $42 mark recently. From the levels of 35 to 42, it has been a very short and very sharp rally which we have seen in the past 10 days. And now the prices are hovering at a very 3-month high. Prices are hovering around 3-month high. So we can expect some prices to getting stabilized around here, because there is some resistance over these levels between 40 to 44. So we can expect the Brent crude to trade between these levels of 40 to 44. And on the domestic side, we can expect the crude prices to trade between the levels of 2900 to 3100 on the higher side. Either side breakout will strongly give a trend impetus to crude prices. So watch out for the levels of 3100 on the upside and 2900 on the downside in crude. The momentum will be strongly volatile, so please do trade with strict stop losses as well. Now, moving on to the natural gas prices, we have seen the natural gas prices trading very volatile in the last couple of months. But if you see the broad range of natural gas prices has been between the levels of 120 to 150, and this has been the case since the month of January to June. As we are seeing it currently, the prices are taking somewhat support at the levels of around 120 to 125. So we are expecting some bounce, but not majorly, as some short covering may be witnessed due to, the summer season has been ended and now we are moving on to the rainy season, and there might be some shortfalls coming ahead in the inventory numbers as well. So we can expect the natural gas prices to trade, keep trading above 120. If and all, if it is trading in a positive territory, I will suggest you to keep going on the buying side with the stop loss below 120 especially. And on the higher side, you can aim for the targets of around 132 to 135, but not going very strongly on the buying side. Keep very light position on the natural gas prices as it is a very strong volatile counter, as you all know. Now, moving on to the last segment of today's weekly commodity update, that is the base metal. So base metal prices have been very strongly on the uptrend since the last 15 days or so, and we have seen a very good buying, witnessed in the copper prices. We have seen the copper prices trading beyond 415 from in the last 1 month or so, and once it has crossed 430 levels, it has strongly moved up to the levels of 450 now as we speak, and we have seen strong support zones being built up at the levels of around 440 to 442. Now, looking ahead in the day, looking ahead in the week, I would suggest that keeping a long positions intact, you should be holding on to your long positions in copper with the stop loss strictly below 440. And any fresh level entrants who want to, buy into this commodity of copper should go long around the levels of 446 to 445, as the counter is looking very strong right now, as it is following the trend of equities where the markets are behaving very fantastic on the upside. And on the higher side, copper will face some resistance around 453 to 455. So keeping your shorts very tight, if you are having a short positions, I would suggest you to keep a very strict stop loss of around 455 odd levels, and keep a lookout for buying opportunities in base metals, especially copper prices. The next base metal which is in very strong momentum is the zinc counter, which has been seeing some strong negative price actions in the last couple of weeks. It has been the only underperformer as we have seen, but in the last week we have seen some strong short covering as well happening. As we have spoken about it, about the zinc prices last week as well, that it is showing some strength at the lower levels, and it is finding some good supports at the levels of around 160 to 162. So we are suggesting to be long on the zinc prices as well. Till the time it is holding the levels of 160, one can be long at the levels of around 161 to 162, keeping a strict stop loss of below 157 for positional traders. And for intraday traders, you can go long at around levels of around 162 with the stop loss below 160. And on the higher side, we are looking at the levels for around 165 to 168 for this week. Summing up with the base metal prices, nickel prices are trading in the range of around 950 to 980. We are looking at this counter as a range bound trade counter as of now. Any side breakout beyond below 950 or above 980 shall give some strong impetus to the prices of nickel. Speaking about the lead and aluminium prices, they are not doing much into the price action. They are hovering around at the levels of around 143 for lead prices and around 136 for aluminium prices. So it is a very range bound trade for lead and aluminium, between 140 to 145 for lead, and for aluminium it is between 135 to 137. I hope each and every one of you would take some good trading opportunities going ahead, and you should follow the videos that we are uploading for you guys. I wish you all a very happy trading, and stay home and stay safe.